This is an organic farm in Devon that puts biodiversity first. Aside from these grazing animals here, this place is absolutely teeming with wildlife. This farm is a refuge for England's rarest bat. The grey long-eared bat is so rare that we'll be incredibly lucky if we see one this evening. These bats need lots of rich grasslands full of insects to hunt, just like this one, which is literally buzzing full of bat food.
The grey long-eared bat has all but disappeared because few farms in England leave space for these wild grasslands.
Bats are apex predators, meaning their presence is physically needed at the top of the food chain to control numbers of insects. If these insects aren't controlled, their numbers can cause problems for crops and livestock, so essentially, they're free pest control for farmers. In this building is the bat's maternity roost. So, adult bats come here in March to give birth and suckle their pups, and then now those pups have grown up, they've left the roost. Now what's clever is that these bats remain loyal to their roost, so those pups will return here to this farm next year to raise their own pups alongside their parents and their aunties, uncles and cousins. Provide a lot of benefit for the farmers, and in return we not only provide them a safe home but a safe place in which to rear their young. And all 8 of the surviving grey long-eared bat maternity roosts across the whole of England can only be found in buildings like this one.
What a massive privilege to get a brief glimpse of one of the coolest animals on earth. To help them thrive again, Back From The Brink is working with farms all over England to make space for the grey long-eared bat.
Grey long-eared bats are also known as the whispering bat, hence the need for big grey ears. Back From The Brink is one of the most ambitious conservation projects ever undertaken. It aims to save 20 species across England, all of which are nearly extinct. It is the first time ever that so many conservation organisations have come together with one focus. And the power of collaborating like this is really beginning to make things happen. Much of this success, of course, is down to the local people. So far, over 2,000 people and counting have volunteered to help Back From The Brink. This amounts to over 4,000 days or 10 years of working days given for free to help our wildlife and wild places. Pretty incredible.